Well, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Minister McCarthy, thank you for appearing before this hearing today.
Thanks for inviting me.
I have several questions, and so if you could keep your answers pretty short and direct. First, as you know, setting the levels for the new source performance standards, the Clean Air Act requires you to select the best system of emission reductions for technology that has been adequately demonstrated. Mm-hmm. Now, we've had several hearings in this committee on the new standards where we've heard testimony whether the CCS technology necessary to meet these standards has actually been adequately demonstrated at the full-scale power plants. I've asked your colleagues from the Department of Energy on a number of occasions if they could give me examples of where full-scale power plants are located, and their testimony is none of them are operating anywhere in the world. If this is true, that full-scale power plants operating now are not operating with CCS technology, how can you say that has been adequately demonstrated?
We believe, sir, that CCS technology has been adequately demonstrated. The technology is proven. It's available. In fact, the coal technologies and facilities that you're seeing being constructed today are actually utilizing CCS.
Yeah. So can you provide me an example of a full-scale power plant that is currently operating with this technology?
I can give you examples of two that are 75% completed, and I can give you an example of others that are coming up. That are also in the planning stages. So CCS for
what would those be?
We have the Kemper facility that's 75% complete, and there is another project in Canada that's also utilizing it at levels much higher than the types of reductions that EPA has proposed in its new source.
Are any of those facilities that you mentioned receiving ENSPS? Funding, clean coal power initiative funding.
It's my understanding that there have been that there has been funding supported by DOE. DOE continues to have funding available for these types of projects.
So they are receiving clean coal power initiative funding.
Yes, that's my understanding.
Well, it's kind of interesting then, because the Energy Policy Act of 2005 clearly states that projects receiving funding from this program can't be used to prove technology is adequately demonstrated. So the examples that you're using are receiving funding, and the 2005 Act says that you can't use those. So can you explain how your logic on that?
Actually, sir, I think we are regulating in proposing this regulation under the Clean Air Act, which is very specific in both its intent as well as its history of application. There is no question that CCS technology is available. The components of CCS have been in place and demonstrated for decades. So the question really is it reasonable in cost, and is it available for this sector? EPA believes it is, but we have proposed that. We're welcome and open to comments. We will be getting to that public comment process shortly.